Hi Vikings, and welcome back to another sCreed Valhalla Mastery Challenge video. In this video, we are gonna do the Templebrough Fort, Bear, Wolf, and the Raven challenges. But first, I'm gonna demonstrate the photo mode in action. As you can see, we can see all the enemies that are around us and a little bit further with Odin's Eye and with the photo mode. But now, let's start the Mastery Challenges. First, we are gonna do the Templebrough Fort Bear. For this challenge, you need melee kills, parries, and killing all of the targets. In my mind, this is one of the easiest of them all. So, what you need to do, take the parries out of the way first. This is gonna be the easiest part, so just parry, parry, parry. If your health is dropping too low, or you are almost dead, just use the offhand attack in order to heal yourself. Try to keep your enemies on the center of the fighting area. You don't want any of them to catch fire and dying by the fire. I am gonna do all of the challenges in real time, so you might be able to copy or go as I'm going at the same time.
Together, lads, we have this. Watch my lead.
Come, brothers, let's end it.
Yeah.
At the last arena, there are three regular guys and two guys with markings on their head, and you don't want to kill those. Why? Because if you kill the marked ones first, and there is still 1 to 3 of unmarked guys, you will fail. You need every kill that you can get. Let's move on to the next wolf challenge. For this one, you are gonna need poison kills, explosive kills, headshot kills, and eliminating all of the targets. For this one, there are multiple of ways to do this one, but one of the best that I did found was starting from the top of where you are spawning. What comes to the explosive kills, you need to be sure that you are getting at least 1 to 2 guys, at one blow. If not, don't worry. There is one trick that you can use in order to get the kills from the explosions. So if there's no old jars or anything left, keep couple of the guys alive till the end, and you can actually set the traps on the dead bodies, and those count as explosive kills. Like in my other videos, headshot kills are best to do by hitting the weak points. After that, aim for the head. This is not easy challenge, but it's doable. And if you take best tips and advices from this video, I'm pretty sure eventually you will get the gold medal for this one too.
Each other's backs.
Christ is surely with us. God damn you. Come, brothers, let's end this. Damn coward.
God won't let us lose. Got your belly, dog.
Let's strip the dog off.
Watch my lead. Work with me. Fast. We have the advantage. With me, bro. Fire!
This was pretty challenging. There is little to no room for mistakes. If you shoot somebody by accident, but they are not dead, that is still good. But if you are accidentally killing any of the enemies, other than headshot, explosive kills, or the poison kills, you need to restart again if you are after gold. Let's move to the last challenge, the Trial of the Raven. For this challenge, you need assassinations, don't matter if they are normal assassinations, ledge assassinations, or air assassinations. Also, you need 5 poison kills, and remaining anonymous, besides the one treasure that you need to loot at the very end. From the very start, start running straight forward so you get behind the tower, go up, you can try to whistle and lure the enemy on the ledge, or when he has his back turned on you, you can go and take the assassination from there. After that, you need to jump down, hide in the bushes and lure the guy near the tower to you so you can take the hidden assassination.
Jesus, what's happening? Using the bushes for cover.
Depending on your timing, you might be able to throw your axe and take the assassination for the next guy, or if you have the same locations with the guards as I did, you need to come here in the bushes and take the assassination in here. Depending on your timing or little bit luck, you can take 3 to 4 guards with the poison kills from here. For me, in this video, I'm only going to get 1, and couple guys are gonna get little bit poison damage, but they are not going to die from the poison. So I take the rest of the kills in this area, but little bit differently than I was expecting. So only one guy is gonna die from the poison over there. Rest of the kills I am going to make for the lonely guys. One at the tower, one behind the tower, and one near the wall. Again, like I have said in other videos about the mastery challenges, the time is your friend. So take your time, be sure that the coast is clear and it's safe to move on. Now I'm going to show you guys how useful the photo mode in these challenges can be. So you can see the whole area where the guards are, where they are facing. It's easy to spot because they have the green glowing eyes. But with the Odin's pulse, you can see enemies at the red, even behind the walls. And with the photo mode, you can see the whole picture, the larger picture, and this will make your challenges much easier. At some points of this challenge, I'm gonna take a little bit more time than I really needed to show you an example that it doesn't matter how long this is gonna take. You can do you, or you can do as I did, but you can make this actually a little bit faster. I'm not going to use the route that was intended, so I'm kinda making a shortcut, and it almost felt like a cheating, almost. So I'm not going to take a right, we need to go far left of this open area. And how we are gonna do that? We turn back, we are outside of the wall, and we are gonna climb the farthest corner possible, so we remain undetected. We are not going to climb all the way top, because the guard is looking towards us if we get there, so he's gonna see us. So we are gonna take our time and hang around. the last two guys that are not in the tower, we are gonna take out with an air assassination, and be sure their back is turned on you. So first take the guy up here, after that climb back on the wall, go to the stairs and wait until the other guard is facing off you. Now we are having only two more guards. The one is guarding the chest and the one is holding the key. There's multiple ways that you can take this guy off and the second guy off, but I did find out this is the one of the fastest way to take them both out. But like always, thanks for watching. See you in the next one. Remember to hit the like, hit the subscribe button, turn on the notifications so you won't miss any of my future uploads or live streams. Have fun, stay safe, be strong my Vikings. See you in the next one. Skatha, over and out. Bye bye.